Cage here is going to be working against the defenders as they do want to try and sustain, but now with this one way, it's not going to allow them to progress inwards. The plant has gone down.
Yep, plant has gone down, but however, 5-man standing for AI, I take that back. VS, all of a sudden, 2-man down post plant, of course. AI looking very good to probably like kick this defuse here. Are they not? RV is in U-Haul King getting those frags, but not before being taken down by PTC. Howsoever, though, they know she is in U-Haul, but with that double peek there. Barbie is insane. I mean, he took out easily 3, remember? However, they are still being split. Oh, he spotted out though. Zest actually gets the headshot onto PTC. That is huge. Alright, but of course, now we got a Spectre. Genie gets a return kill onto the Zest. But Fault Line will actually land onto 1, I believe. No, I'm not sure if I actually hit that. Spike is still dropped, by the way. That's something to note. And they might look to make a rotation towards A.
Yeah, with the amount of damage done to Ginny, they are kind of banking that the rotation might be happening here, but I think, you know, they're just trying to have a little bit of an indication as to how much utility and presence is going to be on A, and looks like they managed to get enough information. King is going to be rotating over here. He might be able to contribute towards the B take. Congrat is also going to now still be in a little bit of no man's land. He hasn't decided as to how he needs to maneuver around, but I think they could see the take here is coming here. Acetix is going to be the first player to go down. That's Glow. He's going to start pushing in a little bit here from the side of the Arches, but the plant is going to be successful, and I think, you know, this is a relatively successful equal round coming out from Vision Strikers.
Yep, getting a plant down, getting 2-man down from AAA, I think that's huge. Alright, but of course we talked about the defending side. They know they usually will come out from a defender spawn. It's really hard to go out there, and then of course next best thing is Elbow, where they got that angle pretty much covered up now. Alright, it's 4 versus 3, but there's 2-man down very low on Vision Strikes though.
Oh, they're sticking the defuse right now, but oh, looks like Ginny here. He's going to be stopping here at the last moment, and looks like the pressure is not going to be enough here for Vision Strikers. They're going to not be able to defend this spike, but
RB is going to take control of U-Haul here, though. He's going to spot it now. No, he actually backs on spike out. The fault line will zone him out. He's get the spike down. That's the Zest one up onto WannaFly. Can he get a little bit more? That is actually a backstep kill, actually. In the meantime, King takes out Congrat, though. Another fault line to actually push them back. In the meantime, it is 4 versus 5 in... sorry, 3 versus 5 in favor of VS.
Oh, Attack All Around is going to be giving up this site here and moving out with whatever weapons that they had left. And you know, after really not having the best of rounds of round number 2, you know, having the Bulldogs here, just not able to stand toe-to-toe in terms of the overall firepower that we saw coming out from Vision Strikers, who are going to be able to essentially have a flawless round, you know, just by being able to keep everyone alive. Though, of course, they're still going to be the two players that they did manage to eliminate, which is going to further hamper. They're going to see Ginny rotating around after I think they realized the impending doom.
Alright, Congrat gets a frag onto King, though that's 1-man down attacking on VS, but not before RB takes out Ascetics. But they are on site already, and of course RB spots out, everyone's rotating from the defender spawn. Here comes a Molly to actually zone them out, though. Have they get the plant down? It's not. They're still chilling. They're in the zone. They gotta be really careful. Here comes the Cloudburst. They try to knock Mass Vision. They will walk over too long to try to maybe get a sniper or two, because Zest is still on that offense.
Yeah, Vision Strikers be able to isolate out Ginny, and now with this 3-man retake, it's going to be a bit more difficult. RB locking the angle, able to take down PTC. No luck happening there, and now going to instantly be able to put up a semi-one-way here in the form of the Cloudburst, but this is not going to be something that we're seeing Attack All Around want to try and challenge. They're actually backing out here towards A Heaven and A Site. So, looks like we're going to have another tie game. And, you know, these two teams are definitely not disappointing here in our decider match.
I am not sure if AAA actually decided to save this round, but VS has already caught up. And now the momentum building up with an AWP, I'm not sure if they really want to go for another, because this is a very AWP favorite map. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and right now, this...
Well, that's why I don't know if they can manage to pursue. Everyone is already rotated in pretty much. Oh, Congrat actually gets a kill onto Glow.
30 seconds left.
Correct though. Wow, Congrat unfortunately did not get the friend of the King, which is really important because right now, WannaFly does get the... Oh, he will spot out everyone left on VS, and VS is now dropping like flies. All of a sudden, it is 4-on-1. They know he's at shower, and he goes the ult as well, just for good measure. But like I said, well, now they're fighting on equal grounds, AAA is going to make a comeback.
Yeah, the execute working out well for Vision Strikers, but not able to prevent further detriment. Not sure if they're going to be able to sustain.
I don't know if they want to go for an anti-beta everyone, though. Here comes the ult, though. And everyone's literally just coming out at this point. That's a big zone for the Aesthetic, and he goes down. RB in the meantime actually takes out PTC.
Left.
So they do have the entry. They have expended their ult in the meantime though, but they are already on site. So the rest of Triple A still coming to get in here. I don't know if they would want to try to make this defuse because it is a 3-on-5 after all with all abilities off cooldown. They might look to just give this to VS.
Oh, I think they got no choice after the Orbital Strike and the Hunter's Fury just clearing out the back of Sight and Cubby. There's not a lot that they can do, and they know exactly how they want to try and push it on the site. Mm-hmm. Just so difficult to stop, and you know, this is also some of the strength of Brimstone really enabling this kind of play. Sky Smoke's just not allowing any of these angles to be opened up from elbow or anywhere else.
And they take so long to dissipate, man. Like, that one's the strongest smoke in this game, of course, and plus orbital
whatever they can, waiting for the smoke to dissipate.
Better in position though. Zest actually gets a kill on the one of fly, but not before PTC also takes out Glow. That is a trade there. But we do have Fortlight. They actually lost control of U-Haul for our defender, so they know it's their Aesthetic. Spawn out the Jet, but Jetix is down to RB! Gets returned naded, but not before taking one two out from VS. And now Ginny also dies. Triple A is probably not gonna get a defuse off this one. VS now on a freaking roll.
Oh, RB with the heads up play, getting the double there, but now look at PTC. He has to decide how he wants to try and navigate this one. I think Stax was thinking a little bit too far ahead that PTC had already moved away from heaven.
These have been top notch. Dear lord, that was Ike Mensch there. Very quickly. But here, we do have the offensive very fast here though. That is a flash, actually. No, that was the fault line actually signing onto Aesthetic, so you can't see anything though. RB gets the kill onto PTC. And right now, VS looking very strong. They are on site already looking to clear this out though before they get any more plans. And of course they saw Omen at window, market actually though, and here comes the boom. Again, knocking up at least four members here. I don't know if they're actually opting to rotate here, but they did significant a lot of noise on the B, and they're pretty sure A is very, very clear. Coming out of heaven, planting default here. Not before Congrat actually takes out RB, so they gotta be really careful here now though. Key player being off. Oh, Ginny spots out Stax. Unfortunately, Stax actually takes him out first. 2-on-4. I think they might be saving.
Yeah, with the really quick two kills there onto PTC and a C-Tix, just getting absolutely sandwiched as they all hopped out of window and rushing through gardens to really take them out. And that served a twofold purpose. They managed to get the man advantage by two and at the same time really prompt the rotation coming out from A, but then they went for the teleporter play and yeah, they're gonna have that relatively exposed A site on completely up to them. And you can already see that Vision Striker is here going for the hunt, but WannaFly is gonna be able to catch down Glow as he's not gonna be able to catch him by surprise and really holding these positions. Not sure.
Relatively slow for this round. Super slow and precise. And it's only 30 seconds left on the clock.
Oh, and they're going to get rewarded for that. King on the lurk here. He's going to be able to get two kills on A. This is epic here for him and the rest of Vision Strikers. But the rest of them are pushing on to B. And they're not going to be denied as they're going to take down a C-Tix. And that's Congrid. But WannaFly, he's got other ideas. He's going to do some significant damage. But King, he's come all the way over there for Vision Strikers to get onto site. They have relinquished control here as, of course, backing out WannaFly, going to be all the way back in showers together with Ginny as they look to plan the retake. But PTC, though, is going to get a bit overzealous, popping out, rather getting popped there by Zest as he's going to try and peek out as best as he can, try and get some initial picks going here. But now Dark Cover going to be working in favor of the defenders as they are going to be approaching here for the retake behind the truck side of things. They're trying to push into U-Haul, but look at the stack here. Three players all here from Vision Strikers, really not allowing them any space to work with, and they're going to be giving up here with the three players they have remaining. They want to try and bring it out solid in the final two rounds of the half as Vision Strikers going to have all five up.
It's just tech. Well, actually gets one, but not before, of course, King like drops himself.
There's still going to be way more people here. They might be pushing through arches here, and looks like the Orbital Strike is going to be coming into the back of sight. They're going to be pushing down arches at the same time. Look at Glow. Exactly. He's going to be able to spot out Congrid straight away, and now there's going to be Ginny reinforcing from the CT side of things. Acetix is still going to be in the backside here, hiding in the smoke. He's actually going to get spotted out there as Stax able to catch him. And now, this is still going to be difficult there for attack all around. They only have three players left.
They've won at tunnels though. The jet is still there at elbow. I think she actually pushed out already. That's fine. Now it is postman after all. The numbers are still okay, but everyone of VS is in position.
This is still gonna be an incredibly difficult side take. They were both dancing there, but the Cypher King will be King, in fact, here for Vision Strikers, and now Zest trading out there as he's going to be able to make it sure that Ginny is the last person surviving here, only going to be able to escape with the Vandal here into the next round, and yeah, a bit unfortunate, but again, you know, with this kind of lead that...
But at the same time, they did find one. Format, even a Cypher rotating back there, but they are holding short a little bit too long there. But then again, to be fair, they don't know where they are. But now they got an info. They got in the smoke location on DC. We have the Omen dropping straight into there. Well, we have U-Haul in the control. Triple A is still doing good though. Takes out stacks. This is fine. Omen. I don't see where's the Omen here though. Yeah, I was talking about Omen takes out King finally. Aesthetic that here is just back and forth. Zest actually misses the shot. That is huge. So in the meantime, that's one up drop on the ground. Now all of a sudden, VS dropping like flies. That's one more.
10 seconds left.
He's going to need to make that plan. Well, he is on the other side already with 7 seconds left on the clock. Can we get that down? Yes, we can. But there's a flash. Guess flash actually misses out though. Gets one frag. No, he does not. PTC actually takes out RB. Hey, 4-8. What do you know?
Oh yeah, this is exactly what the Tide team needed here. And attack all round. Going to be putting another one on the board to finish.
Have trust in their flashes and their smoke spread.
Yeah, so Dark Cover is coming out. It's going to cut the sight in half here. And just not able to push in just yet. I think U-Haul, they're all just going to be stacking here. It's quite the party here. And now this is not going to really prompt them too much. But we see Spike King planted with the Cyber Cage here. It's going to give information there just how many times it was moving. But RB is good here with the Super Shorty. He's going to take down two players here, both jumping in. And now with the plant down, this is going to be a potentially good sight retake here coming out from Vision Strikers. Though PTC still trying to land the shots, not able to take down the player. It's going to be Ginny instead. But now the CTX, the last person left, is going to nade out the Diffuser. Potentially, no, it's not going to get it. And RB with the 4K as Vision Strikers. They are going to be extending the lead to 5 points here.
And look at this guy. Not sure what he's planning for though, but this is very good. In the meantime, Glow picks up a member. Wanna Fly is going to drop right there. And that's your Scouter. So, oh, I can't see what's happening right there. King getting two of that. What is going on? Well, we were talking about anti-eco round, and
well, right now I think they did fake that they went to be there, as of course the drone didn't catch out any player, but Zest is going to be all the way here. He's not able to take down PTC there with the judge and the CTX. He's going to be able to catch one, but not the second left, as they rotate here through the B showers, and now, or rather the B teleporter here into showers, but now look at them. They're going to be taking the teleporter all the way to A here, and Glow, he's just not able to get out in time. Wannafly is going to be able to punish two of them, as now he's making it absolutely known that Attack all around, is going to be able to get the plant down on A.
That's
on B.
That's really, really crazy. I mean, that's what the teleporter's like real location is there. They can just cause a lot of like noise right there at A and then fake towards B. And then it makes it so hard for defenders at A to come and rotate back. And we're not even talking about defenders anymore. Like, hello, there's only a jet left.
Yeah, indeed, and this is dealing significant damage to Vision Strikers as a result. And I'm not sure if you noticed at the start, ladies and gentlemen, that you know, we did see the Owl Drone coming out from Zest all the way from U-Haul to really try and scan through A short. And Congrid, he actually saw that. He didn't get spotted out, but the drone didn't see anything, and he communicated that they were going for that intel gathering. And as a result, we saw attack all around rotate all the way back to A short.
So we know everyone's in A. 3 smoke being used already. Left. Wannafly gets the engagement onto stacks as well as Glow taking out Wannafly in the meantime. Well, that's background there. King gets onto Congrat and another Ginny goes down. King, you're actually mad this game as well. Well, RB, that's a chat on chat action, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, AAA is dropped down to one man. Okay, they still have to plant this though. 8 seconds left on the clock. The Cypher is very low. Here comes the shock dart, and as Aesthetics takes out Click, Zest with the clutch, and we're talking 5-11.
Well, CTX almost did it there. I mean, it was a 1v3 situation. He still took out RB with the crouch peek.
The drone actually did spot them out though. They need to clear the angle here. Actually gets one peek out there. PTC takes out Zed. That's one of your key players drop out. Your cage as well. Keeps in there. King can't get the frag onto him. I say like that. What is going on? King with that Spectre. Takes out two of triple A. And we're talking about very, very close to the match point here. But still very close. 5-11 with 3 men left on each team. Our Glow is still having a judge. So only close proximity. Oh my god, Conrad actually almost died to the Molly.
Well, scintillating, the spray transfer coming out from King is going to be dynamite, but the rotation coming out here through the B teleporter as they're going to streak back onto A, but now they're going to be wise of this kind of tactic as RB is still holding the site. He's going to claim two there. The bunny hopping not working out for them, and there's only going to be Ginny that's left trying to sustain, and he's just going to be hiding out in showers with the spike as 15 seconds left on the clock. And this 3v1 not really working out there. They can land the shots though, and he's actually going to be saving the gun. Yeah. And you know, the reason why we did see that attack all around still went for the B side despite getting spotted out by the drone. Mm-hmm. It was all place in our upper bracket finals, which is going to be happening tomorrow. But right now, this is still going to be on the cards here for attack all around. They can still fight back here from this, but look at this. I think they're going to be a bit apprehensive after the aggressive push here with the camera on the B long side of things. Not going to yield any information, and as a result, they're going to be rotating heavily here onto A. But look at this rotation, or rather the ultimate popped out here from Congrat. It's going to be offering quite a bit of information. I think they know what's going on in the site, but the plan is going to be successful. There's going to be quite a bit of presence overhead as RB is going to be watching out on the showers. He's going to be obstructing quite a bit of lines of sight. Now he can start focusing on the rest of sight.
They're not. They shouldn't lose any more people though. A is ready to have the sniper. The RB and Stacks, they're fragging. And when I say they are fragging, they have just won game number 3 against Triple A. And Triple A will be knocked out to the losers bracket.
Oh my.